3D was a big promise. Everybody was talking about it. It was gonna be on your TVs. It's gonna be on road signs and everywhere you look, the world was supposed to be three-dimensional. Here's the thing, it never really caught on. I think the biggest part of that reason is the fact that you had to wear these funky looking 3D glasses and people didn't wanna wear them. The real thing that got me excited at the time was this idea of naked eye 3D. That's right, I said naked. 3D without fancy, funky glasses. This is a phone from a company called Alienline. They were like, we have a naked eye, glasses-less 3D smartphone. I did a little bit of research, found out that it's an Indiegogo campaign happening right now. I'm gonna have a link in the description if you wanna check it out, but their claim here is that they've got the 3D smartphone of your dreams and it will not require funky glasses. Seems pretty crazy. Let's take a look at this phone. So it's gold and look at that big badge, not for sale. So they've certainly sent me their prototype. I hope it's not their only one, but they sent it to me. It looks to have, maybe that's a fingerprint reader on the back. I mean, a pretty standard smartphone layout. Power brick, micro USB cable, and a headset. Okay, so pretty standard stuff. The banging intro track. Now the first thing I notice is the display in general kind of has like almost a layered look to it. When I do that, make that little adjustment, you can see how it's different. Essentially, you're looking at a pretty basic Android layout, but the magic happens in these icons up here. K3DX gallery, 3D video camera, 3D player, and 3D camera. Obviously, you're not gonna see those things on a standard Android device. That is unusual. I'm fairly certain that you will not be able to make that out because after all, you are looking at a single camera lens, not, you know, stereoscopic eyeballs. Maybe one day. It can take 3D content, movies, and make that available here without the glasses. All right, so I don't know, let me, what the? Ooh, whoa, whoa, that is very 3D. The thing he's poking me with is right around this range. Again, you can't see that. What do you see? You just see, oh, that's actual 3D. Wow, I did not expect it to be this effective. I really did not. It looks good. It's almost like the effect gets better and more comfortable the longer that I look at it. They've preloaded some provocative images in here. Would you say that's provocative, Jack? Look at the images all in the gallery. It's obvious who loaded this up. This must have been Jack, in fact. My understanding to make your own 3D images, when you snap a photo, you keep moving upwards. Got it. That's super bizarre. For verification, we're bringing Chaz in. He's gonna tell you people.
Oh, wow.
What, do you see it or not?
I can see it. He's got like a bunch of tools and it looks three-dimensional.
These are not 3D glasses on your face.
Yeah, it's working with or without the spectacles.
Chaz, say hello to the world. Say hello. There he is. Okay, so the last one to try here, GMAX 3D game. Maybe like a little bit of a 3D effect. It looks mostly like a 2D game with like a little bit of extra tiny bit of depth. Honestly, I've tried a lot of different 3D on TVs and such. This is some of the most effective 3D I've seen. And you can't really see it, but I promise you, these are legit 3D video files. Naked eyes. These are naked eyes. Well, they have these glasses. These eyes are naked, okay?